What's up, everyone? I'm Anthony Armstrong from the band Red, and today I'm here to teach you how to play Feed the Machine off of our new record, Until We Have Faces. This song is tuned 2.5 full steps down from standard E tuning, and you're going to be basically in B standard, and then you're dropped in drop A, so it's drop A tuning. I'm using a 74 gauge string on this guitar, which is basically the bottom string is bigger than a bass string on a regular four string bass, so it's pretty low, and your fingers take a beating, but once you get used to it, especially with this style of music being tuned as low as it is, it doesn't let your strings get all spaghetti on the fretboards. On this guitar, I'm actually also using EMG pickups, which I absolutely love. I'm using the 8185 models. Looks like you can see yourself with the mirrors, pretty awesome. The structure of the song is actually pretty cool. It basically starts out with your intro, goes into the intro riff, and then starts the first verse. Coming out of the first verse, you've got a pre-chorus into the chorus, and then the turnaround, which basically is the main riff of the song. And then it goes back into a second verse, another pre-chorus, another full chorus, and then gets into the really, really heavy bridge. On the record, it's got a very epic ending, so we're basically playing the chorus over and over again, but live we usually do, I think we play through the chorus 4 times. So I'll break down each one of the different sections of the song, give you an idea of how to play them, how we play them live. It starts out with a palm mute, and it sounds a little bit something like this. That's the basic riff, palm muted, and then you'll hear this crazy loud scream. Our singer Mike just basically coughs up a lung, and then you hear the riff full on open, no muting at all, and it sounds like this. That's a basic riff, and that slowed down is simply you're going to start on the 6th fret of the top string. It goes like this. Now when you do that bend, there's 2 different bends in this song. It's on the 1st fret, and you'll hear sometimes the bend sounds like this. And that's actually bending up to the original note. So I'm actually starting the string is actually bent going into the original note. Sound like, but then when the song starts and the riff kicks in loud, you're actually bending up instead of bending back, so it sounds like this. To slow down again, it sounds like this. Just an open heavy chord. Goes right into the verse riff, and the verse riff sounds like this. That slowed down is this. On the record, we didn't do a slide, but live it's kind of cool. I slide from the third fret of the top string, and you do a shake on that on the sixth fret of the second string. So it's like sounds like this up to speed again. So after you play the riff, there's these 3 pickup notes, the heavy, pretty simple. That's 8th fret to the 3rd fret to the 5th fret, just power chords. And then there's a pickup, quick little pickup riff back into the verse riff. So it just goes 5th, this goes 5-3-6. So the whole thing sounds like this. Okay. Okay, so out of the verse riff, you're going to go back into the main riff of the song, which becomes the pre-chorus, which is four bars of the original riff, and it goes like this. So coming out of the verse riff, this is what you're going to play. The whole pre-chorus. To get into the chorus, you actually finish the riff by going to the third fret and do a pull-off. It sounds like this. Okay, so in a lot of Red songs, over the power chords, we actually add major, minor tensions on this song, actually, to make it sound, because I'm the only guitar player in the band, to make it sound like there's actual two parts going on. I'm barring the note, the first note of the chorus at the eighth fret, and I'm adding the ninth tension. So it gives that almost octave sound, so it sounds like there's actually two parts going on. So the chorus coming out of that last part of the riff goes like this. And that's the chorus. Okay, so coming out of the first chorus, coming out of each chorus of the song, there's a turnaround. And the turnaround riff, there are single note stabs. And it basically sounds like this. It goes. That's the turnaround back into the original riff of the song. So that slowed is this. Okay, so coming out of the turnaround, you go right back into the main riff of the song, which leads you to the second verse. So since I've already showed you the second verse riff, there is a small change that happens in the pre-chorus going into the second chorus after the verse. It's you're gonna do there's a quick little pause, and it sounds like this. Like the drums stop, everything stops. It's like a quick stab stop there, and it sounds pretty cool. But slow down, it's. Okay, so at this point in the song, when you get to the second chorus, this is obviously leading you up to the bridge, to the breakdown of the song. Now, in the breakdown, there isn't really any distinguishable guitar parts until you get to the four note stab leading into the bridge riff. Basically live, we're doing a lot of cool stuff with loops and programming. And on the guitar, I'm actually using my delay pedal I actually use the DD20 Boss delay, Giga delay, and it's got that, there's a setting on there called the twist. And I basically, the sound makes the guitar ramp up really, really high and then come down. So it kind of gives it the chaos that the song has in the bridge. But leading into the bridge riff, it starts getting heavy again, and then you're gonna basically, all you're gonna do, you'll hear this. And then it starts the bridge riff, and all that is, figure on the first fret of the second string, and you're playing the top two strings, and it just goes, and then it leads you right into the bridge riff. So the whole bridge is this. So that slowed down is this. You do the four stabs. And it goes. And that leads you right back into the outro chorus. Now, in the you're going to play through that chorus, I think, twice, and the outro actually changes. So at the second time through, that last chorus is this, and then you'll hear the change. Basically the outro, and that just continues on through the end of the song. There is another cool part that's on there. It was a really cool delayed layering part, and basically all that is, you'll hear this actually a lot through the you'll hear it a lot in the turnarounds of the song. But that's this. And all that is you're up here on the 11th fret and the 15th fret on the top two strings, and you're toggling back and forth between the two, alternate picking, and you switch to this position, and it sounds like that. Gives it that really dissonant, nasty sound over top of the actual chords that you're playing. So, and then that's it. That is Feed the Machine.